Good morning, everyone. I didn't stay awake until 2 this morning following the antics on the floor of the United States Senate. I'm going to try this new process. I hope this works. It may not get a lot of viewers, but let's try it. There is no greater disgust I feel right now than to see how deep the swamp has become in Washington, D.C. We see clear majorities in the House and in the United States Senate, along with our President, Donald Trump, who's committed to the repeal of Obamacare. And what do we see instead? No interest, no convictions, no willingness to do anything. Enough's enough. I remember receiving a fundraising letter from the National Republican Senatorial Committee, and I wrote in big red letters on it, "Ditch Mitch." It was evident from the moment that he gained the majority and became the majority leader again that he was more interested in governing than he was in fighting the corruption, fighting President Obama, and ensuring the enforcement and protection of our rights, along with enacting clear reforms. McConnell's been in Congress, I think, since the mid-1980s, in the U.S. Senate, mind you. Pardon me if it's a little awkward. I want to make sure my information's accurate, so I'll be looking stuff up. I might be going back and forth. Bear with me. Let's find out, how long has Mitch McConnell been in Congress, in the Senate specifically? Should have had this ready, but that's all right. I'm pretty sure he had a congressional career. So thanks for bearing with me, folks. This is a call to action, people. We've got to put an end to this nonsense. If you've got other ideas on what needs to be done here, but we have seen a rogue U.S. Senate. Dealing with the House of Representatives has been a lot easier to do. I mean, every 2 years, they're accountable. You're able to throw them out. Hi, young Jim. How are you? Good luck on your bid for Board of Supervisors, by the way. Sorry for the aside. But anyway, Mitch McConnell, this is beyond disappointing. I read an e-blast that was released by the Senate Conservatives Fund, which outlines that from the very outset, McConnell was not going to repeal. He was interested in providing bailouts for insurance companies. Let's see here. This is me trying to be as ambidextrous as I can here. All right, two-handed as possible. So whatever you want to do, I'm just trying to figure out whatever way is the fastest we can to get people on board to do this. So McConnell has been in the United States Senate since 1985. Think about that. He's been in office longer than the millennials have been on the face of the earth, or than the post-millennials. I do not support term limits. I don't think it's effective. I live in the state of California. We have term limits, and we have seen state senators go rogue and vote against the best interests of the people who elected them. More importantly, the Constitution they swore to uphold and defend. This is Mitch McConnell, folks. He's been in office since 1985. He's definitely a swamp thing. He's definitely a swamp creature. If anybody has any ideas on how you get rid of a U.S. senator who is so arrogant and unaccountable, I'm listening. But term limits, I'm not sure is the way to go. What is the way to go? The first suggestion, I actually reached out to the, let me see. There's a website, ditchmitchnow.com. I urge you to visit that right away, ditchmitchnow.com. That's put together by the Senate Conservatives Fund. They're getting behind true conservatives that have a real record of accomplishment. Full disclosure, I did donate money to them. They haven't given me money. I applaud this idea of sending in real primary challenges and forcing candidates to abide by their oaths of office and fulfill the promises they made to their constituents. Give me a sec here. Something else I decided to do. I called the Kentucky GOP office, and I guess they're based in Frankfort, Kentucky. So you can go to rpk.org. You'll find contact information there. Let me see. Here's the phone number for the Kentucky GOP, 502-875-5130. 502-875-5130. I say start calling in right now and demand that they rescind endorsements and pull all the money from McConnell. Tell them to issue a censure and demand that he step down. Something else that maybe we all need to start looking into is, do these different states have recall procedures for these U.S. senators? Brenda Mitchell, yes, Mitch McConnell is from Kentucky. He's in the Bluegrass State. He had a primary challenge in 2014. It was Matt Bevin, and Matt Bevin is now the governor, and he has enacted incredible reforms, including the right to work, reinstating the Bible as literature that can be taught in public schools. He's also been fighting to protect the religious liberties of state as well as private individuals. I'm not in a bar, everybody, but I am in a restaurant. I decided to put this out right now to see if this would be effective. I don't know. I mean, there's different ways to do this, but the idea that we just have to sit back passively and allow Washington to do whatever it wants and not pay attention is not acceptable. I do know also the Arizona Republican Party issued a number of censures against John McCain. They've done the same thing to Lindsey Graham as well. But I think we as citizens, as voters in this country and in the state, in our separate states, we need to put together better processes for keeping our U.S. senators in line. I understood in the past U.S. senators could be recalled. The legislatures elected them, and the legislatures could pull them out and say you're not doing your job. So if you've got other ideas on what we can start doing as voters, I'm listening. But this is just getting ridiculous. I'm not going to accept no repeal. I'm just not going to accept it. Obamacare must go. It must be repealed, and more regulations must be repealed in turn. The phone number again for the Kentucky Republican Party is 502-875-5130. The fax number is 502-223-5625. I'm gonna invite people to follow really quick. I'll try to keep this short, wrap it up. And then I'm gonna look at the e-blast from the Senate Conservatives Fund. I'm sorry, I hope I'm not bothering you. Okay, I'm as mad as hell because Obamacare is not being repealed right now. I'm fed up. So I'm on a live feed, but I'll keep you off of it. But I'm just fed up.
I'm so fed up with the board that you see. I worked all my life. Pay taxes, I mean, they come out normal. Nothing against that. If I had it my way, I shouldn't even say it, but I'm so pissed off. I would replace the whole goddamn rotten gang in Washington, D.C.
I'm going to repeat what you said. I have a gentleman here who is as pissed as I am. I'm not going to put you on record. I'm just repeating what you said. You're not on. I'm not videotaping you, but you know, I'm with this guy. He would repeat every person, every goddamn person in D.C. Throw him out. I mean, it's just
Start all over again.
Yeah, I wouldn't have a problem with that.
I send him to a Russian gulag.
I mean, they're
to cool them off. 5 years minimum. Give all the water they can drink and 2 pieces of hard rotten bread a day and hard labor.
So what do you think of that? Maybe we should start imprisoning these politicians, put them in a gulag. I mean, we're being imprisoned into this terrible healthcare system. This is like, I mean, this is prison. To go after healthcare like this and turn it into a government subsidy is prison.
It could be done, but you have to start at the moment, at the place where it's affordable for everybody, because other countries have it. Other countries have it who are not anywhere near as rich as we as a whole are.
I think the problem is, I'm not a single payer fan myself. I think we need to liberalize it much more. The prices need to be clear. I've been studying in other countries who have single payer, and they put a single payer bill on the floor last night, and everybody voted against it. I don't blame them. It's too costly. It's too expensive. German, Russian, or I hear your accent a little bit.
No, don't put that in there.
I won't say that. I totally respect. It's looking at me. I promise. So you don't have to tell me anything you don't want to. But I couldn't agree with how frustrated you are.
I'm not sure of the guy speaking.
Deutsche Sprach. Das ist gut. So, I mean, I'm not the only one, folks, neither are you.
I don't want to be on.
Not at all. Don't you worry. It's just looking at me, so.
No, I'm just saying, because I'm mad as hell the way it is.
Yeah.
I think I cannot complain what I have. But I work from since I'm knee high. I don't know any difference, and I did for more than anything.
Yeah.
But the gap between the big, the gap between the big.
It's gotten out of control. There's so
too many giveaways just so they can get in their vote there.
Oh, exactly. I couldn't agree more. The welfareism that's overrun in so many parts of this country is outrageous. It was good to meet you. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Have a wonderful day.
Are you a reporter?
Yes, I am. I'm a reporter. I'm a journalist. Yes, I am. And I am fed up with what I'm seeing in Washington, but I'm just not going to sit back and take it. Obamacare has to go. I'm not going to accept it not being repealed. It's got to go. So I'm live right now, and I don't want you to be disrupted. Yeah, I don't blame him. Yeah, so you know, this is one of the ups and downs of being in public. When you do this, some people will come by and say something, and some people won't. Part of the reason I'm going live to see if this will work. Call the Republican Party of Kentucky 502-875-5130. Let them have it. Let them know that McConnell needs every endorsement poll. McConnell shouldn't be getting one more dime. If there's a recall process in Kentucky, they need to initiate it.
By the way, that's not just the Republicans, that's both sides.
Yes.
Who screw it up.
Yeah, absolutely. We're seeing so many entrenched, arrogant, elitist politicos who don't care about anything that's going on.
Here is what I said the other day to somebody. If you have a piece of shit in here and a piece of shit in here and switch it, which one is better?
None of them.
That is a crude way of saying it.
This is what we're seeing in a lot of places, yeah. They'd say it in Brazil, in elections you have a choice between filthy and dirty.
Looking better right now.
It's getting that way.
It's getting real bad.
Yeah. Venezuela is what socialism looks like at its fullest, and I don't want that here in California.
It doesn't have to be done.
Never has to. Thank you. Yeah, so this is what we're dealing with, everybody. If this is not an effective way, if you got another way to do it, I'm listening. One of the things I learned from Milton Friedman was, we need to get the wrong people to do the right things. You know, it's one thing to get someone new elected. It's even better to be stepping on their necks and making them change their mind. Why is it that these, who are these politicians listening to that seem to have so much power that they don't think they have to listen to us? We need to start undermining that. I don't agree with the Bernie Sanders types. The answer isn't to try to take all the money out of politics. I think it should be easier for you and me to donate as much or as little as we want to. I think donations should be anonymous if you're an individual, for example, no matter what the amount you spend. So let me go to an email that was released by the Senate Conservative Fund. This has been forwarded everywhere. So this is from Cuccinelli. He ran for governor in Virginia as a real conservative, and he didn't get any support. Senate Republicans failed to keep their promise to repeal Obamacare this week and have decided to drop the issue altogether. It's a total disgrace, and Mitch McConnell bears the blame. Yes, he does. With the 7 Republicans who opposed clean repeal should be held accountable. They should be. It was McConnell who created the environment that encouraged their betrayal. He made it easier to do that. I'm going to interrupt really quickly. 2 people have now indicated that a poor couple jumped to their deaths. They committed suicide because the medical bills were so high they couldn't pay them. That is tragic. That's sad. I have never accepted the notion that people should commit suicide. There's always a way out. The sense of desperation that people feel needs to be counteracted with the truth, with the gospel. There's always a way out, no matter how bad things may seem. We need to start asking some more serious questions, like why are the medical costs skyrocketing the way they are? Why is this happening? It's happening because of massive regulation, massive government intervention, abuse of power. This is why it's happening. You can go back to the 1920s, the 1930s. People had pre-existing conditions. People suffered from cancer. Even if the technology wasn't as refined or nearly as advanced, men and women were able to get health care as needed, and they paid the doctor off in installments. Thomas Sowell talked about when he had his first child with his wife, they received a bill following her delivery of the child, and they paid it off in installments. They were able to do it. There was a direct transfer of of money for the service. For some reason, people think that's wrong, but to treat healthcare as a right doesn't mean that it will be more available. It will actually, ironically, lead to more rationing. It will lead to less care. It will lead to less. More health problems. Single-payer countries are not the way to go. We need to see clear reforms. We see corrupt corporate influences that are relying on government subsidy and intervention to protect their own bottom line. That's the problem. You know, Bernie-crats may not like the inordinate corporate influence, but it's because of the government. It's not because of the free market. You can read Adam Smith's book on the free market, and he'll tell you that business owners try to undermine the market forces. You know, they want to avoid having to as much as possible. But, you know, clear transactions, competition forces businesses, forces services to provide a good service. So anyway, back to the e-blast. McConnell's use of the party's massive political machine to defend those senators, the ones who voted against repeal, something the party, has made them much less accountable to the Republican voters who elected them and much more willing to break their promises. Lisa Murkowski of Alaska, John McCain of Arizona were protected from competitive primary challenges, and they both know they will be protected again as long as Mitch McConnell is the leader. Quick history update. Lisa Murkowski actually lost her primary in 2010. Another Republican defeated her in the primary. But instead of supporting the new Republican, McConnell supported Murkowski, who was technically an independent at that time then because she didn't win the Republican nomination. So right away, that was a pretty corrupt outcome. Keep in mind also that in 2010, other establishment picks or incumbents lost their primaries. In Utah, for example, a guy named Bob Bennett, was knocked out within the first round of voting in Utah. He actually cried. He couldn't believe he got kicked out like that. Mike Lee became the U.S. Senator. And Mike Lee is an excellent U.S. Senator. He gets 100% rating from the American Conservative Union. Ted Cruz is also very, very close. I think he's about 98%. Ted Cruz was the outsider pick, and he defeated the establishment pick in Texas. So we need to find ways where we as citizens are having the power in the primaries to choose the candidates we want representing us, not allowing Washington swamp thing special interests doing it. So Murkowski and McCain were protected by McConnell. McConnell's early decision to abandon repeal in favor of keeping some of the worst parts of Obamacare encouraged others to do the same. The leader sets the tone for the process. The leader sets the tone for the battle. And McConnell was indicating from the outset a very hesitant unwillingness to repeal it. They had a full repeal placed on Barack Obama's desk in 2015 and 2016. How come that wasn't the first thing they did the last time? How come? Because it was a show vote. But for us, it wasn't about show, it was about substance, and they didn't follow through. So they don't follow through, we throw them out. McConnell's prediction that a bipartisan bailout would occur if repeal was to fail also gave moderates a reason to hold out for something else. You know, good leadership is about telling your team how it's going to be. It's not just placating your team and doing whatever they want. That's wrong. We need to see real leadership in the United States Senate, which is beholden to the Constitution and the best interests of every American citizen and the long-term status of our government. And to allow Obamacare to continue to have more bailouts, or worse, to lead to a single-payer outcome is beyond hideous. We just cannot sit down and allow this to happen, folks. We have to stop thinking strictly in terms of Republican or Democrat, and recognize that as citizens, as taxpayers, as engaged and aware voters, we don't have to tolerate it. So once again, everybody, this is the number for the Kentucky Republican Party, 502-875-5130. If someone could do me a favor and type that in the comments, I'd really appreciate it. I can try to type it now. Give me a sec here. I'm going to do this as best as I can. There's going to be some noise you'll hear, but Kentucky GOP 502-875-5130. Now, why are you calling them? Because they are the state party. They're the ones who are supposed to be supporting the candidates and ensuring that they stay, that they toe the line for their party values. So that's what I need you to start doing. That call in if you have relatives in Kentucky, if you have contacts in that state, start calling in right now. We need to send a very loud and clear message. If somebody can find out who the donors are for Mitch McConnell, what you do is go after them and pull their, and tell them, if you don't pull your funding, we're going to stop buying your goods or services. There's a large dental lobby in the state of California. Maybe it's time for us to find other ways to take care of our dental care. I don't know, but that's what you have to start doing with these politicals. Go after their money. I was ready to protest Chad Mays here in the state of California, who voted to raise my gas tax 71 cents. We went to his fundraiser, they canceled the fundraiser. So that's a lot of money that he doesn't get to raise on that day. That's what you have to start doing. Okay, so Republican Party, who else? Call your U.S. Senator if you're not watching in California. I've got Kamala Harris and I've got Dianne Feinstein. I'm not sure I'm going to get a lot of support from them, but it's time to start calling other U.S. senators and tell them, hey, ditch Mitch, he's got to go. You need leadership that's going to actually stand and do what's right. I refuse to accept Obamacare repeal dying. I'm not going to tolerate it, and neither should you. I tried this out going live. Let's see if that will work. I've given you that number. Trying to call Mitch McConnell's office is not effective. The phone is always busy, always busy. You can go to his Twitter feed. Let me see. I'm going to see if I can find his... his Twitter handle. Everybody, if you look up Mitch McConnell's Twitter handle, start going after him there too. Annabelle Sanchez. I would have no problem with Ted Cruz as the majority leader. I think Mike Lee would be great too. Hello, Assemblyman Tom Lackey. How are you? Assemblyman Lackey, we could use your help too. You know, we didn't just elect you to fight for us in Sacramento. I need you to fight for us in Washington as well. I saw Young Kim earlier. You guys need to fight and fight harder. I don't want decorum anymore. Civility is killing us. Civility will not help us fight for our civilization. I've said that before. We decided not to be really extra nice to Mark Steinort's staff. We were very angry to see our gas taxes hiked in our face, and their response was to call 25 sheriff's deputies on us. This is what's happening. We're more than pitchforks and torches at this point. We're angry citizens, and we're going to flex our muscles as residents, citizens, taxpayers in this country. We don't have to tolerate this. You don't have to roll over for this and just accept it. So, tweet to Mitch McConnell, reach out to the Senate Conservatives Fund. Let me go back to that e-blast and wrap it up. The truth is, McConnell began the health care debate with no endgame strategy for repeal. He was simply going through the motions to make it look like he tried. This is the problem we've seen with a lot of elected officials. They go through the motions, they say, I fought, I did the best I could, but it didn't make it. All the Republicans voted for the repeal because they knew it wouldn't pass because Obama would veto it. So, hey, they did what they could. They could go to their constituents and then beg for their votes for the next election, but nothing passes. He was simply going through the motions. Now this is his failure theater, and he wants to give up and move on. And you can be sure it won't just stop there. McConnell wanting to give up on Obamacare. You're going to see McConnell wanting to give up on defending First Amendment rights. You're going to see McConnell wanting to give up on Second Amendment rights. Anything that's going to shake Washington or drain the swamp, these are things that he's going to resist. Whoever has the big banks, whoever's on K Street or J Street, they're the ones who are going to get the first and final word. We're learning about this in California, and we need to get aware of it in Washington. Honestly, I don't even support term limits for elected officials. I support term limits for lobbyists. I think that would solve a lot of our problems because they're not able to create the connections. We should have all the connections, not the people in Washington. So, it's time for Senate Republicans to replace Mitch McConnell with a new leader who will fight for conservative principles. I couldn't agree more. McConnell has no policy convictions. He has no interest in fighting. He has an interest in just getting along and going along. I'm going to be posting some stuff. Anybody else has any ideas? I'm listening. If this is effective, great. If it's not, there's other means we can use. Thanks for watching. We need to repeal and replace Mitch McConnell. He needs to go. We need to take on more of the swamp, not the less. Not less, not just arbitrarily sit back and expect them to the fight. It is our government. It's we the people. It's not they the government, they the elected officials. It's on you and me. And there's a lot of us that can make a difference. So thanks for watching.